The meaning of which is such a beautiful chain of words. We are giving salutations to the goddess Saraswati, who is pure white like jasmine, with the coolness of moon, brightness of snow, and shine like the garland of pearls, and who is having strings in musical instrument in her hand, and the boon giving staff, and who is seated on the pure white lotus, who is always adored by Lord Brahma, Lord Achyuta, that is Lord Vishnu, Lord Shankara, and other devas. O Goddess Saraswati, please protect me and remove my ignorance completely.
And with this beautiful prayer, here we are starting with our FE special event. The capacity to learn is gift, the ability to learn is skill, and the willingness to learn is choice. We are very much happy to see your excitement, and we are equally excited as well.
But learning is not everything. Developing the skills is equally important.
Developing skills is not enough. Applying the skills in your life is important as well.
But applying is not fine. Applying is fine, but succeeding is essential.
But only succeeding is not enough. Happiness is in that success is important. And then our life would be heaven. And here, we are at the first step of our happiness.
Yes, Shubhasya Shigram, which means it is always good to start early.
Yes, we have to continually jumping off the cliffs and developing our wings to weigh down. So now, I call upon President of SESA, Mr. Kapil Kalpe, to guide us all.
Good morning, everyone. As our CSD is rightly mentioned, presentations and communication skills are very much important in our life. And I feel that these two qualities are the landmark qualities that every engineer needs to have in order to excel a person in his or her field. And today we are privileged that we have our Kulkarni ma'am and Manglekar sir, who will guide us regarding the same, like how we can develop our communication skills, how we can develop our presentation skills. And without wasting much of our time, I, on behalf of Civil Engineering Students of Association, I welcome Kulkarni ma'am, I welcome Manglekar sir, and I hope you guys will be learning too much of things in this particular. Over to you, CSDs.
Thanks a lot, Kapil.
Thanks a lot. Behind every event, there is a motive behind. Then only we can accomplish the event. So, for guiding us for the motive behind this event, I would like to invite the Vice President of SESA, Mr. Sagar Kohn.
Good morning, one and all present here. I am Sagar Kohn, Vice President, SESA. And firstly, I welcome today's guest. SESA is a civil engineering student association, which is run by the students for the development of soft skills and technical skills for all the students who are joining the SESA. And we have tried our best for the development of these skills. And to take such an initiative, now today we have planned this event, that is present or dexterous. By keeping this motto behind is, for every engineer or for every person, presentations are very much important. If you have an idea, a very good idea, and if you fail to express it, then you can't get the output which you want to get from this idea. So for this reason, presentations are very much important for everyone. One has said that if you want to learn something, then first step is very much important for that reason. Like for every building, the founding stone is important. That is, foundations are important.
And it's okay, na? It's okay, na?
Yes, ma'am. Okay. For this reason, we have planned that we would keep the founding stone for this event. That is, by this event, that is presentations, which are very much important for everyone. And by this, we would like to give this event. Okay. And I assure that in future, CESA will always take such initiatives for the development of skills in this way. With this, I would like to stop and over to CSTs.
Thanks a lot, Sagar, for guiding us with the motive of this event. Now, before welcoming our guest, I would like to give some introduction of him. Mr. Rohit Manglekar, sir, is a B.Tech pass out from Civil Engineering Department of WCA Sangli in year 2013. He was awarded with his M.Tech degree from College of Engineering Pune in 2016. He worked at Sihagad College of Engineering Wadgaon, Pune for 2 years, and currently he is pursuing his PhD at Civil Engineering Department of Walchal College of Engineering Sangli under the guidance of Professor Dr. K.S. Gumaste, sir. We welcome you, sir, and I request you to guide us all. If you want to share your PPT, you may share. Over to you, sir.
Thank you very much, Sanraj. Thank you, Madhura. I thank the president and the vice president of CESA for inviting me and allowing me to share my experience, I would say. Guidance is something bigger, but I'm here to share my experience over the period of time, what I have learned. I guess in between I can speak Marathi. Is it okay, Madhura, Sanraj, and the respective president?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Thank you. Karan Kasai, whenever I am trying to teach you some rule, probably that will be in English, but if it is an emotion, it will come out in a mother tongue, that is Marathi. So first of all, I feel very humbled and very joyous because me swatta CESA cha club service director hoto. I was a club service director of CESA, and I have been part of CESA during my undergraduate program. And हे सगळं द वे यू आर हँडलिंग इट अँड द तुमची जी जुगलबंदी होते अँकरिंगची द वे यू डिड इट इट इज व्हेरी गुड द इंट्रोडक्शन्स अँड द स्टार्टिंग पार्ट्स वर व्हेरी गुड मला परत त्या काळामध्ये गेल्यासारखं वाटलं सो थँक्यू व्हेरी मच फॉर इन्व्हायटिंग मी अँड गिविंग मी ऑपॉर्च्युनिटी टू रिमाइंड दोज मेमरीज रिमेंबर दोज मेमरीज सो Let us start with the presentation. I had requested the CSDs to let me present because there are some timings you will get to know what it is about. So I'll share my presentation. Just give me a moment. So I hope this is visible to you.
Yes, sir, it is visible.
Yes. And my voice is clearly audible, Sanraj?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. So this is the topic on which I'll be talking upon. So the event is presented extras. I would ask all the participants to look at the screen carefully because this is about the PowerPoint presentation. So small details are very important. So what I am talking about is the preparation of PowerPoint presentations in academics. Okay, aplyala sadhyacha kaalamadhye whatever knowledge we bear, okay, je tumhala yetu, or you will be given some kind of task, some project, some seminar work, and you are supposed to share it with the others, your colleagues, or maybe in that case the faculty. So in that case, you need to have some tool. You need to have some medium to convey your thoughts, whatever understanding you have about the topic. You need to have the tool, and that tool most commonly used is a PowerPoint presentation. I'll talk about some other advanced tool later on. The one thing I want to share with you is, tumhi sagle khup advanced aht. The younger generations are being more advanced. I just saw the video of this advertisement of this particular event. That was wonderful. Another club software, because I am connected to a number of people, so I got to see that video too. So there is a very good animation. So what I want to convey is, hit tools kashe vaparayche yacha tumhala definitely you have a very good idea about this, about the latest tools and techniques and technologies that are being brought up. But while using these tools in academics, there are some rules that you need to follow in order to have a synonymous or we can say comparable evaluation. Pratyekana jar aplya paddhatini karal tar it will be difficult for the evaluator to understand your presentation. There will not be a flow. Okay, so for that purpose there are some rules. So I'll just go through some of the rules. Not 100% rules are possible to cover because these things go on changing. So I have been introduced by the Sanraj already. I'll first talk about the history of presentations. Why do we need to know the history of anything? The first very common reason is आपल्याला माहित असते की हिस्ट्री इतिहास आपण का शिकतो किंवा ऐकतो किंवा वाचतो. तर भूतकाळात काही अशा गोष्टी असतात, काही चुका असतात ज्या पुढे रिपीट होऊ नयेत. ओके, दॅट इज अ मोस्ट कॉमन अंडरस्टँडिंग अबाउट द हिस्ट्री. बट द नेक्स्ट रिझन यू कॅन सी दॅट दिस इज अ टाइमलाइन फ्रॉम 13,000 BC टू द प्रेझेंट स्टेटस ऑफ द प्रेझेंटेशन मीडिया हॅज बीन शोन थ्रू द टाइमलाइन. वी ऑल्सो नीड टू अंडरस्टँड दॅट वी आर अ पार्ट ऑफ धिस टाइमलाइन. आपण या इतिहासाचा भाग होणार आहोत. सो व्हॉट एव्हर वी डू, व्हॉट एव्हर वी प्रेझेंट ऑर व्हॉट एव्हर वी यूज राईट नाव, लेट अस से फॉर पीपीटी, इट इज गोइंग टू बी ऑब्सोलीट वन आर अदर डे. उद्या याच्यापेक्षा ऍडव्हान्स मीडिया किंवा मीडियम येऊ शकतं प्रेझेंटेशनसाठी. सो जस्ट टू नो दॅट वी आर गोइंग थ्रू द हिस्ट्री. सो वी कॅन सी अर्लियर द ह्युमन यूज टू राईट ऑन दी ऑर ड्रॉ ऑन दी स्टोन्स ऑर द केव्स. Then paper drawings were used, posters were used, then projectors came. Again, in the projector, there are a number of items, and now we are using the PC computer, in which there are a number of softwares like Microsoft Office, and PowerPoint presentation is a part of it. So as I said, you will be presenting the PowerPoint presentations for these many reasons, probably, in academics. For seminars, mini projects, BTech projects, MTech projects. So each of these has got a deeper understanding of the presentation. In a seminar, you will be just taking a certain topic and just presenting it. Okay, in mini project, you will be doing some work. You will be doing some actual work. In a BTech project, a further depth will be given to the work. And in a research like a PhD, there will be a wide and depth, very wide and depth, deep understanding to that research. So the presentation is I guess these pictures are visible to you.
Yes sir.
Can anybody amongst the audience, if they are allowed, can just start the speaker and tell me what is this? I'm trying to define the presentation. Can someone summarize this picture, the pictures I have shown quickly? Has anybody seen this movie?
Excuse me sir, your slide hasn't changed. It's still the first slide.
Okay, it
hasn't changed. Yes sir.
Okay. Is it visible now?
No, sir.
Sir, your screen is not
presented. Okay. Give me a moment. So the presentation is, I've shown some pictures. Can anybody tell the name of the movie, or do you get the idea of what is this?
Hello?
Coco.
Absolutely
Coco.
Right. This is a very, very nice movie. I love this movie, Coco. So I've just taken the movie for the sake of defining the presentation. This is what the presentation is, a story. Presentation is nothing but a story to be told to the audience. So I had shown the pictures in some haphazard pattern, and now I'm just putting them in a sequence of a story. Then there will be the end. So what is this story? Generally, if you look at any movie, then there will be some background established for that movie, for the events. Then there are some characters. Then there will be some events within that story. Okay, some joyous moments, some let us say sad moment, sad events. Then there will be a climax and happy ending. Our presentations are similar to the story of a movie. And how they are similar? Initially, we set up an introduction. We set up an introduction, why we are presenting, why we have chosen this particular topic. We establish the reasoning for that particular presentation. Then there are different parts and sections into which we divide our presentation. Okay, that is very important. Unless and until your presentation has been divided into the parts or sections, then the audience will not understand the beginning and end of particular section. Okay, then there will be method or methodology and conclusion from whatever understanding you have you had for that particular topic, and then there is a sigh of relief. Because everybody knows that presenting in front of some audience is always something to be scared of, right? So ekda ka presentation jhala ki khush ani apan aplya chair var yeun basto. So there is a similarity between the story of a movie and the presentation. Now why the presentations are important? This may be one of the reasons, because 83% of the information that we information of the object that we see or that we feel comes through the sight or through the eyes. So this is a very good media to convey the information or the knowledge that you are trying to speak upon. Okay. How a presentation should be has been summarized in this sentence very well. If you are very good at reading, then you will understand the meaning of this sentence, because the particular phrase is repeating over here. Tell them what you will tell them. Then tell them what you have told them. And who has said this? Not me. This is not my sentence. This is the sentence of a very great philosopher, Aristotle. Probably your situation will be something like this after reading this statement. What is this? Tell them what you will tell them means, first you are supposed to tell the audience what you are going to talk about. Tumhi kashabaddal bolnar ahat? What is your topic of presentation? That is to be told in advance. That is for the first part. Then you are going to actually talk about that topic. That is the second part of the sentence. Then tell them. And the last part of the sentence, then tell them what you have told them means, again summarizing what you have talked about throughout your presentation. So this sentence is actually about the speech, how to give a good speech, but it is also applicable to the presentation as well. Now this happens in most of the presentations in academics, that students don't know the formal structure of the presentation, how to start the presentation, what sections I have to divide the presentation into. So these are the sections into which you must divide the presentation, or a better presentation, we would say. So first part is introduction, motivation or significance, then literature review, objectives, and you can read on. I'll just explain each of them. I have talked about the introduction already. It is the background of your project, seminar, topic. We'll talk about this in a bit elaboration. Then the motivation. What is the application of that particular topic? What are the highlights? Some current standings. Is there current activity going on related to that particular topic? Current advancement that you should talk about in a motivational significance, or why you have chosen this particular topic. Then literature review is a part where you study all the things which have been studied about that topic in past. See, not all the topics are presented for the first time. Now, ata ha jo topic ahe, how to give the presentation or the academic presentation, it has been presented by the people already in past. So I can study them, I can refer them in my presentation, which I have done. You will see that. So literature review is about what has already been done in your topic. You need to study that first and present it. So that is a literature review. Then objective, what is the objective of your presentation? That should be clear, distinct, and gettable. It is a part of the project. You cannot just define the objective that is not gettable, that is not quantifiable. Je major karta yeto, te objective paije. Then scope of the study means how much work you are going to cover in the presentation or in your study.
Excuse me, sir. Sir, your voice is not audible.
There is some network issue. We will wait for some time.
So Madhura, are you thinking like this session is becoming more fruitful for us? Like we might understand many things.
Yeah, definitely. But yeah, from audience, can somebody tell the short summary what sir told right now?
Especially from Effie.
Yes. Sir, join.
Okay.
Oh, I'm really sorry. I just got disconnected. I'm really sorry for that. So screen share झालेले माझे दिसते आता?
सर अजून नाही.
Okay. So I was talking about this. Have you got this? References and I talked about the references are the most neglected part, and references means you cannot have all the content in the presentation of your own, but you refer to some people, some study, and those references are to be included. And then the annexures are the additional parts, additional data information that you can include. Now let us talk about the first and foremost important thing which will give the first impression of your presentation, and that is nothing but the title slide. So that is why I asked you to observe the slide carefully. So we can just talk about this slide itself, the title slide of this presentation. You can observe each and every component. First, I have written down the event for which I'm presenting, that is the Presented Express. Then a presentation on, or a seminar on, or a mini project presentation on, like that you will just write the reason for that presentation. Then the title of that particular topic. In bracket, I have given the font size. So the font size of the title is generally 60, or you can have a bigger or near to that 60, 58 will be okay. See, about this font size, the content should be readable. That is the only condition. Why? Because the content on the slide will vary. Now on this slide, there is only these titles and the name of the presenter. But in the other slides, you may have the contents like tables, figures, some description, definitions, bullet points. So accordingly, the size of the font have to be varying slightly, but still there is a norm for the font size. I'll talk about that also. So then there will be a title, then presenter, designation is very not all because this presentation will be preserved as part of that particular institute.
Excuse me, sir. Sir, your voice is breaking in between.
Yes. So is it okay now?
Yes,
it okay
now, it's fine.
Okay. So I have included the logos of these two institutes. The first one is the Walchand College of Engineering and the association SESA. So this is a typical title slide, and the contact details. This is not for the academic presentation. Whenever you are presenting outside, let us say for a particular company, you may include your academic details. But the very important thing that I have not included in this slide is the name of the guide, because the academic presentations are generally driven by some instructor, the guide. So the name of guide shall also be included without failing. That is very important, because आपले मार्क्स जे असतात शेवटी ते गाईडच्या हातातच असतात. सो गाईडचं नाव टाकायला विसरायचं नाही. देन अ बिट अबाउट हाऊ टू राईट द इंट्रोडक्शन. अ पिक्चर इज वर्थ 1000 वर्ड्स, एव्हरीबडी नोज दॅट. सो जस्ट फॉर द सेक ऑफ एक्झाम्पल आय हॅव टेकन दिस पर्टिक्युलर एक्झाम्पल. प्रोबेबली यू हॅव सीन दिस, यू हॅव वॉच सम व्हिडिओज अबाउट दिस टॉपिक. सो दिस पिक्चर इटसेल्फ कॅन give us information about what is the topic. So this can be a title, this can be the slide of the introduction where I talk about some statistics. I talk about that the intensity of the topic. Okay, this is the practice which is still being conducted in some of the parts of India and Bangladesh and Pakistan. So probably this can be a picture you will be using to start the introduction. Again, there's a one difference while talking about the introduction or including the part of introduction in your presentation. When you are giving a seminar or assignment, and when you are supposed to take the different topics, which is not individually you take the different topics, not all the students are taking separate topics. In that case, your colleague, your classmate will not know about your topic. त्या वेळेला तुम्हाला introduction मध्ये बेसिक कॉन्सेप्ट इन्क्लूड करणं गरजेचं आहे. बट इफ युअर फॅकल्टी, इफ युअर प्रोफेसर इज द ऑडियन्स, स्पेसिफिक ऑडियन्स, ही इज गोइंग टू इव्हॅल्युएट यू, त्यावेळेला त्या टॉपिक मधलं त्या फॅकल्टीना माहीत असणार, ही विल बी नोईंग अबाउट दॅट टॉपिक. सो डोंट ट्राय टू इन्क्लूड टू मच ऑफ द बेसिक्स. सो देअर इज गोइंग टू बी अ बॅलन्स इन बिटवीन कुठून स्टार्ट करायचं. एखादा तुमचा समजा टॉपिक असेल, फॉर एक्झाम्पल लेट अस टेक अ फ्लुइड मेकॅनिक्स वरचं एखादं प्रेझेंटेशन देत आहे. वॉट इज फ्लुइड, वॉट आर द डिफरंट टाईप्स ऑफ फ्लुइड्स, इथून जर स्टार्ट करायला लागला तर इट विल बी व्हेरी बेसिक अँड तुमचा फॅकल्टी ही विल नॉट अंडरस्टँड, ही विल नॉट ऍक्सेप्ट दॅट. इट इज टू बेसिक, वाय यू आर स्टार्टिंग फ्रॉम दिस पॉईंट. बट लेट अस से यू आर टॉकिंग अबाउट द CFD, कॉम्प्युटेशनल फ्लुइड डायनॅमिक्स, दॅट इज अ व्हेरी स्पेसिफिक टॉपिक इन द फ्लुइड मेकॅनिक्स, देन यू विल नीड टू इन्क्लूड द बेसिक्स. So remember this difference. Now while adding the content to the slide over add karnara content kay asto, kela janara content kay asto, tar descriptive information aste, definitions astat, data, statistical data asel, tables, figures, graphs astil, Gantt charts astil. A very simple idea to include the content of the slide is, पहिल्यांदा काय करायचं, जो काही कंटेंट आहे तुमचा कुठल्याही फॉर्म मध्ये असू दे, मेजरली इन अ टेक्स्ट फॉर्म, तो आहे तसा ऍड करायचा. फर्स्ट ऍड ऑल द कंटेंट दॅट यू हॅव ऑन द इन द प्रेझेंटेशन, देन यूज फिगर्स, स्मार्ट आर्ट्स, फ्लो चार्ट्स, पाय चार्ट्स, टेबल्स टू कन्वर्ट द टेक्स्ट इन टू द अदर फॉर्म, इन टू दीज फॉर्म्स, व्हॉट एव्हर आय हॅव टोल्ड. टेक्स्टला जेवढं काही टेक्स्ट, जे पॉसिबल टेक्स्ट आहे, समजा आता यू हॅव गॉट द एज अँड द लेट अस से फॉर एक्झाम्पल फ्रॉम माय स्टडी टाइम ऑफ वेकअप, टाइम ऑफ स्लीप, असा तुमच्याकडे डेटा आहे, हे तुम्ही टेक्स्ट फॉर्म मध्ये नाही लिहू शकत. सो त्यासाठी टेबल तयार करावं लागेल, किंवा एखादं जसं मी आता इथे एक स्मार्ट वर्क वापरलेलं आहे, स्मार्ट आर्ट वापरलेली आहे, आय हॅव शोन अन एरो, सो यू कॅन, हे टेबल मध्ये सुद्धा आलं असतं, ऑर इट वुड हॅव बीन प्रेझेंटेड इन अ बुलेट पॉइंट ऑल्सो. सो दिस इज presented in the form of a smart art. So you can use the smart art like this. And last, jo kai remaining content ahe, tyala descriptive form madhe present na karta, try to present it in a concise form. Okay? Using the less words. So this is a very common mistake, statements versus description, or statements or descriptions are put by you. Most of the students, what they do? जो काही कंटेंट मी तो आहे तसा टाकायचा, स्टेटमेंट आहे तसे टाकायचे, अँड जस्ट दे जस्ट गो ऑन रीडिंग द प्रेझेंटेशन, रीडिंग द स्लाइड्स, नॉट डन. यू नीड टू इन्क्लूड द बुलेट पॉइंट्स इन युअर प्रेझेंटेशन अँड टॉक अबाउट इट, बिकॉज द PPT इज अ गाईड, इट इज अ टूल, इट इज अ मीडियम, नॉट द वन यू शुड डिपेंड अपॉन. नाउ कलर ऑफ द स्लाइड दॅट यू आर गोइंग टू प्रेझेंट, not one slide, all the slides, or we can call it as design. In a PowerPoint, it is a design option. So what that color should be? Let us talk about this. Can you see this? There is no technical problem.
The screen is completely black.
Yes, there is no problem with the, there is no technical problem. The screen is black. The slide is black in color. I have actually some content written on it. You cannot see it. This is the worst case of all. If you keep the dark colors of the slide, then the not only the audience, even you will not understand, or you will not know what is written. If I use the background with some pattern, then again it will be difficult for the reader or audience to read the content on the slide. If I shift the background to a bit lighter color, but still there is a difference between the color of the font and the color of this slide. So this is how it will look. See, this is not to be taught. This is the perceive. How do you perceive the colors? You should have the color contrast. Ata कोणाला तसा प्रॉब्लेम तरी जर असेल कलर ओळखणं मधला, देन ही विल ही ऑर शी विल फेस द प्रॉब्लेम. सो अदरवाइज यू नीड टू अंडरस्टँड द कलर कॉन्ट्रास्ट अँड देन अकॉर्डिंगली चूज द कलर ऑफ द स्लाइड अँड द कलर ऑफ द फॉन्ट. सो आय हॅव शिफ्टेड द कलर ऑफ द स्लाइड टू लाइटेस्ट, दॅट इज अ व्हाईट बॅकग्राऊंड. अगेन हा कलर असा आहे की बॅकग्राऊंड इज क्वाईट व्हाईट अँड देन इट इज द फॉन्ट कलर इज अ डार्क ब्लॅक, टू एक्स्ट्रीम कॉन्ट्रास्टिंग कलर्स. इट इज अ बिट coming onto my eyes. If I shift that background color to gray one, then it is bit smoothing. Okay, so bit soothing. So accordingly, you can choose. Just remember this: the color contrast should be taken into account, color of the font and color of the slide. I want you to read this sentence because I am of a opinion that being a good human being is very important nowadays than being a good engineer. That is what we lack nowadays. Then मी कुठलाही सेंटेन्स मला ऍड करताला असता आय चोज दिस वन बिकॉज आय वॉन्ट यू टू रीड इट अँड रिमेंबर इट. देन द फॉन्ट कलर, सी अगेन अर्लियर आय हॅड यूज द डार्क कलर्स फॉर द फॉन्ट. ब्ल्यू वापरला होता, ब्लॅक वापरला होता, आय हॅव युज्ड येलोइश कलर. आता याचा एक्झॅक्ट शेड कोणता हा प्रोबेबली द गर्ल्स विल टेल दॅट, बट आय विल कॉल इट एज अ येलो कलर फॉन्ट. सो अगेन द कलर कॉन्ट्रास्ट इज व्हेरी लेस. व्हाईट बॅकग्राऊंड आहे, त्याच्यावर येलो कलर आहे, इट इज नॉट गुड मॅच. If I change it to the green one, then a bit good idea of what is written on the slide. Okay, so that color contrast you need to understand. Now the most common question, what should be the font size for the presentation? I have included the different font size. The first, the title of this slide itself, that is a font size, it is of a 44 size, then 40 32 28 20. This is the size of the font that I have used. Most commonly for the middle part, the content slide, the 32 size is used. I'll show that in the next slides. The title font is 40 to 44, the content font is 20 24 or 28. Now why I have chosen this, this will vary according to the content. Mostly if there is a lesser content on your slide, you can go for the 28. If there is a much content, much more content, then you can go for 20 or 24. Generally 24 or 28 is the size of the font for the main content. Then for the footer you will go for 12 to 14. It is very important to divide your slide into the sections. The first section is a header section. Apan tela header section mhanu, jyacha madhe tumcha title kay ahe slide cha he asnar ahe, ani te pratyek slide var appear hoil, karan tya slide var kay lihilela ahe kalnyasathi tacha टायटल असणं गरजेचं आहे. सो टायटल प्रत्येक स्लाइडवर असलं पाहिजे. देन देर इज अ मिडल पार्ट और कंटेंट पार्ट, ज्याच्यामध्ये तुमचा ऍक्च्युअल कंटेंट येईल, फिगर्स, फॉर्म्युले, पॉइंट्स, एटसेट्रा. अँड देन देर विल बी अ फुटर सेक्शन, ज्याच्यामध्ये डेट, स्लाइड नंबर, नेम ऑफ द इन्स्टिट्यूट, लोगो ऑफ द इन्स्टिट्यूट इफ इट इज कंपल्सरी यू विल हॅव टू यूज. ओके, यू कॅन लुक ॲट दिस स्लाइड. देर इज अ मेन टायटल, सब टायटल, content is placed on the left side, and the figure on which I am going to talk about, or this particular person is talking about, which is me, is placed on the right. Figure right side la ahe, ani footer portion madhe je ka scheme ahe, if you are presenting as a research scholar, the date and the slide numbers are very important, don't miss it. Figures and diagrams baddal sudha kahi rules ahet. सगळ्या फिगर ज्या आहेत थ्रूआउट युअर प्रेझेंटेशन, ट्राय टू कीप देम ऑफ द सेम साईज. प्रत्येक फिगरला कॅप्शन असलं पाहिजे, आणि त्या फिगरला लेट अस से तुम्ही स्ट्रेस स्ट्रेन कर्व घेता एखाद्या बुक मधून, एखाद्या मटेरियलचा, तर तो कुठून घेतलेला आहे त्याचा रेफरन्स दिला पाहिजे. प्लॉटेड ग्राफ जर तुम्ही प्लॉट टाकत असाल प्रेझेंटेशन मध्ये, त्याला कॅप्शन्स पाहिजेत, ऍक्सिसला टायटल्स पाहिजेत, एंटिटीचे युनिट्स पाहिजेत आणि लिजेंड्स पाहिजेत, इफ एनी. फॉर एक्झाम्पल मी इथं सायटेशन दिलंय मांगलेकर एट ऑल. जेव्हा नंबर ऑफ ऑथर्स असतात, दोन किंवा जास्त ऑथर्स असतात, तेव्हा आपण एट ऑल वापरतो, आणि इयर ऑफ पब्लिकेशन. यू कॅन सी दॅट इन दिस स्लाइड आय हॅव केप्ट द साईज ऑफ द फिगर सेम. मी फिगरला नंबर दिलेला आहे, फिगरचं नाव कम्प्लिटली एक्सप्लेनेटरी आहे. फ्रिक्वेन्सी डिस्ट्रीब्युशन ऑफ टाइम ऑफ वेकअप ऑफ सर्वेड इंडिव्हिज्युअल्स ऑन वीकडे. सो फिगरचं टायटल हे कम्प्लीट एक्सप्लेनेटरी असलं पाहिजे. फ्रिक्वेन्सी डिस्ट्रीब्युशन नाही चालणार, graph of frequency distribution nahi chalnar, it should be self explanatory so that person will get the complete idea. Ani ti figure kutun ghetlele ahe tacha reference bracket madhe daycha. Caption with the full details and citation. Jo figure ha graph asto tumcha tevha legends takne mahatvacha ahe. Number of graphs asli tar kutlya color cha graph ha kay indicate karto. Axis titles are important. One more thing about the presentations is the slide dimension. Don type che slide cha dimensions aplyala available at PowerPoint madhe. First one is the standard size and other one is the wide screen. Standard size is the 4x3, which is generally used for the portrait mode devices. बट आपण अकॅडमिक प्रेझेंटेशन हे पीसी वर देतो, प्रोजेक्टर वर देतो, म्हणून दे शुड बी ऑफ अ वाईड स्क्रीन 16:9 टाईप. सो चूज 16:9 टाईप आई चूजिंग द स्लाइड साईज. रेफरन्सेस, दिस इज द स्टाईल ऑफ रेफरन्सेस. म्हणजे काय, मी जो कंटेंट वापरलेला आहे तिथे कुठेतरी ह्या ऑथरनं जे ह्या रिसर्च पेपरमध्ये लिहिलेलं आहे ते मी वापरलेलं आहे कुठेतरी. तर ते जेव्हा तुम्ही रेफरन्सेसमध्ये लिहिता तर ते कसं लिहिलं पाहिजे, ऑथरचं नाव एकापेक्षा जास्त असेल तर दोघांची नावं, सरनेम फर्स्ट, टॅनेम्बो इज द सरनेम, इयर ऑफ पब्लिकेशन त्या पेपरचं, बुकचं, आर्टिकलचं नाव युझिंग एंट्रोपी इन वॉटर डिस्ट्रीब्युशन नेटवर्क, जर्नलचं नाव, पब्लिकेशनचं नाव अँड व्हॉल्यूम अँड इश्यू, ते जर्नल कुठल्या व्हॉल्यूमचं आहे, त्या जर्नलचा व्हॉल्यूम अँड इश्यू काय, अँड देन द पेज नंबर. दिस इज अ स्टाईल ऑफ सायटेशन, एपीए अमेरिकन सायकोलॉजिकल असोसिएशन. आपण सायटेशन करताना किंवा रेफरन्सेस लिहिताना वेगवेगळ्या स्टाईल्स वापरू शकतो, बट इंजिनिअरिंगमध्ये जनरली एपीए सायटेशन स्टाईल यूज केली जाते. मग मटेरियल टाईप जर बुक असेल तर इन टेक्स्ट सायटेशन हे कसं असेल, सॅपोल्स्की 2017. आणि बिब्लिओग्राफी म्हणजे रेफरन्सेसमध्ये कसं लिहिणार, तर हे दिस इज हाऊ इट इज गोइंग टू बी रिटन. इथं अजून एक एक्झाम्पल दिसतं की टेबल हा कसा इन्क्लूड करायचा. सो टेबलचं जे टायटल असतं ते आपण टेबलच्या वरती लिहितो, टेबलला नंबर असतो, टेबलचं टायटल सुद्धा एक्सप्लेनेटरी असलं पाहिजे, आणि जो कंटेंट आहे टेबलचा जनरली सेंटर अलाइंड असला पाहिजे. व्हेरी इम्पॉर्टंट थिंग, जर टेबल तुमचा खूप मोठा असेल, खूप कंटेंट असेल, तर त्याचा फॉन्ट साईज तुम्ही 14 पर्यंत रिड्यूस करू शकता. जनरली वी डोंट गो बियॉन्ड 20 or 24, बट 14 पर्यंत रिड्यूस करू शकता इफ द टेबल इज बिग अँड इट हॅज गॉट लार्जर कंटेंट. शेवटी रेफरन्सेस तुमचे असेल लिस्ट करायचे असतात, व्हॉट एव्हर आर द रेफरन्सेस दॅट यू हॅव युज्ड, यू आर सपोज टू लिस्ट देम इन आयदर क्रोनॉलॉजिकल ऑर्डर. क्रोनॉलॉजी म्हणजे काय, टाईम लाईन जे काय आहे, ओके, 1941, 1993, then 1997 accordingly, and or you can go for the alphabetical order according to the citation method you are using. Lastly, I have included a slide to tell you why these PowerPoint presentations are not that important. They are important, but they are not solely important, because a good presentation is made up of it requires practice, good communication skills, and a PowerPoint presentation. If it is very good, it will enhance your presentation. Knowledge, confidence, a good content, knowing the audience, these are also contributing to it. तुम्ही हे काय सगळंच एका व्यक्तीला सगळंच शक्य नाही. वॉट एव्हर मॅक्सिमम थिंग्स यू कॅन ग्रॅब अपॉन अँड गिव्ह अ गुड प्रेझेंटेशन. फायनल थिंग, टू मच ऑफ एनिथिंग विल, अति तिथे माती आपण जसं म्हणतो तसंच आहे, टू मच ऑफ एव्हरीथिंग विल रूल युअर प्रेझेंटेशन. टू मच रीडिंग ऑफ अ स्क्रीन इज नॉट गुड, टू मच टेक्स्ट नॉट गुड, टू मच कॉम्प्लिकेटेड कंटेंट, काहीतरी कॉम्प्लिकेटेड फॉर्म्युले टाकलेले आहेत बट ते एक्सप्लेन करता येत नाहीत, टू मच अॅनिमेशन्स पण आहेत, it is also not good. So try to balance between these things. Finally, I'll tell you the rule of 10-20-30 given by Guy Kawasaki. He's an American author. 10 slides, 20 minutes and 30 font size. Apan aata sagikade 30 font size thevat nahi, but it is just a rule. These are the references of my presentation. And at the end, I would like to remember my friends, my class of 2013, BTech Civil 2013. I would like to dedicate this song to them. Thank you very much.
Thanks a lot, sir, for explaining the things in much simpler and understandable manner. I'm sure we would be surely benefited by your guidance.
Yes, thank definitely.
You. Thank you. Yes, thank you very much.
Now, before welcoming our next guest, Ms. Anushree Kulkarni ma'am, I would like to share more information regarding her career. Mrs. Kulkarni ma'am has a degree of MA in English. Her research area is professional communication. She is a topper from the Karnataka University, Dharwad, and she is currently working as the assistant professor at Vanchan College of Engineering, Sangli.
Also, she is diploma holder in Deutsch, that is German language, from the Karnataka University, as well as trained at Goethe University, Pune. She has vast experience in industrial staff training and HR department for more than 12 years.
Every year, she coordinates the Present Around the World competition, that is PATW, conducted by the Institute of Engineering and Technology, helping in the development of technical presentation skills in the students. Various seminars, presentations, debates, etc. are conducted under her leadership to develop the English professional communication skills of the students.
So now I request our next guest, Mrs. Anushree Kulkarni Madam, to guide us all.
Hello, am I audible to you all?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, I'll be sharing my screen so that I can show the PPT to you all before beginning the presentation. Just a second. Okay, can you see the slide now? Hello?
No, ma'am.
No, ma'am.
Just wait. No.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Yes, yes.
Your PPT has been already presented.
So you can, okay, that will be better then. You can show the slides from your side.
Okay, ma'am. Will it be fine?
Just wait. Yeah, no problem.
Okay,
no
ma'am.
No problem. You can share it from your side. Take it to the first slide. Okay, good morning, students. First and foremost, thank you all. I feel very honored to be a part of this CESA event. I thank all the CSDs here who have invited me for this event. And I would not like to name any one or two of you all because all of you all have been my student, right? Almost all of you. So today, what I'm going to speak is on the presentation skills. Sir has spoken about the technical presentation, how to prepare a technical presentation, what are the small things that you need to keep in mind while preparing, and of course, how to make it a good one, an effective one. He spoke about that part. What I will be speaking about is about the other aspects of presentation skills. The other aspects include the importance, the nature of the presentation, your body language, visual aids, and all the other things. So let's begin with our presentation. Next slide, please. Yes. Okay. So we said this is Leni Leskowski, who says that half the world is composed of people who have something to say, but they can't say it. And the other half has nothing to say, but keep on saying. What does it mean? That we need to develop this skill. This skill needs to be developed. Otherwise, you need to work upon it. Only then you can be good speakers. Okay, next slide. So what is an oral presentation? We'll try to understand that first. We say oral presentation is a form of oral communication. It is very, very formal. It is structured. It is participative two-way communication. That is to, you are communicating to someone, to the audience there. Okay. And it is a participative communication using, which is formal in nature, which is always structured. And we say, by using visual aids, we try to prove something. We try to make our presentations more goal-oriented. We try to prove a point. So always the presentation will be made with a definite purpose. When you prepare a presentation, you people know, the seniors know here, the first years, the FY students, when you prepare a presentation, there needs to be a purpose of presentation. Okay, what does that mean? Why am I presenting? What is the topic that I'm going to deal with? So purpose of presentation is very important. Secondly, the presentation, as it involves both the speakers and the receivers, it is an interactive process, because whatever I present, I'm presenting it to my audience there. And the audience, most of the times, they are very, very active. They want to catch you somewhere where you go wrong or you don't cover up. It's an interactive session. And as we all know, it's a formal situation. Formal, where are these conducted? It may be in the form of seminars, workshops, or it may be a student presentation, team presentations, departmental presentations, etc. So they are always in formal situations. And lastly, what we say is it's meant for the audience. The topic will have to be dealt from the point of view of the audience. How will the audience take my point? Will they accept it? Will they reject it? Or whatever I'm presenting, how should I present it? In a strong manner, in a convincing manner, we say. And as professional students, you may be required many times to make presentations. It may be student seminars, it may be research presentations. So whenever you present, you need to remember these points. That is, firstly, it is done with a purpose. It's interactive. That is, the audience should be involved. The way you present should be such that you involve even the audience, the most demotivated audience, they say. Even they should feel that there is something to listen to. That is the way we should present it. And we said it's an interactive one, a formal one, and of course, audience. It's always meant for the audience. Yes, next slide. So this is what we understand by the presentation. Now, when we say presentation, we always begin with the planning. Planning of the presentation is extremely important. How do you plan it? You first try to know your audience, stimulate the interest in the audience, make them interested in what you are saying. Be sensitive to their needs and expectations, we say. That is, what are they expecting from you? You should be sensitive towards that. Know your purpose. Always know why you are presenting. Your purpose should be very, very clear. The occasion where you are speaking, whether it is in what, on what, I'll be speaking in detail on all these four points. And of course, choosing of the title, the subtitle, and all these things, which are very, very important in order to persuade the listeners to listen to what you are saying, to share your information, to keep the listeners know how you do something, to demonstrate, you need to keep them involved in what you are saying. Okay, so choosing suitable title is important. So we generally start with the first one, that is knowing the purpose, knowing the audience, where you are presenting, to whom you are presenting. These things are very, very important. Okay, in my next slide, I will discuss about the audience there. Just please change the slide there. Next slide, please. Now, what do you understand by knowing the audience? Now, having understood what is the presentation, we'll try to understand what do I mean when I say know your audience. First is, who are they? Whether you are delivering your content to some students there, whether you are speaking to your colleagues, whether you are speaking to some professionals, or some seniors, it may be your professors here. Who are you addressing? Who is the audience there? Recognizing that is the first thing. Once you recognize your audience, the second question that arises is, why are they here today? Are they here to gain some knowledge? Are they here to share whatever data you share, to accept it, to reject it, to you want to make them think over that? So the purpose of the presentation should also be analyzed at the beginning itself. And once they listen to you, what do you want them to do? Do you want them to feel motivated after listening to you? Or sometimes, or take some action? Okay, so different reactions are there once you present. So, but what do you want them to do? Obviously, we all want our audience to be motivated by what we say when we present a presentation. Nobody wants a presentation where the audience is not interested, that they are not paying attention to what you're saying, or they are creating a problem there. We come across such audience also. I'll tell you how to deal with them. Okay, so what do you want them to do after listening or while you are presenting? Next comes, how can you solve their problem? What does that mean? Whether I will be able to reach out to them, whatever is their problem or the problem statement, whether I can reach the audience through this presentation, whether they accept my what, or are they going to resist? Suppose I give a solution problem and you don't accept what I'm saying, they are going to resist me. How are they going to resist? They can be debates, they can be counter questions. Your seniors know that. When you go for a presentation, at the end of presentation, there are lots of counter questions asked on all the minute details there. And what may be those questions? You try to figure them out first. What may be the questions they are going to ask me? And what's the best way to reach them out? The best way is through fact, in a logical manner, you address the problem statement or the problem or the topic you have taken up. What does that mean? Logically, with the help of stories, with the help of facts, figures, anecdotes, we try to reach out to the audience. So when you speak for 10 minutes you're speaking on a topic, initially we need to break the ice. That is called as an icebreaker, that is, you don't know the audience. So how you're going to connect with them? And then think about how you're going to do that. What is it you're going to present? And then you come to the main point, that is, who are they? Make an analysis. So next time you prepare a presentation, always analyze your audience. Like, who are they? Why they will be coming over here? And when you present, what are you going to present to them? Okay, I hope I'm in very simple language so that you people can understand. Since majority of the audience today is from the first year. So when you prepare it, you need to prepare it on those grounds. And if at all they resist, whatever you say, they don't accept. They are going to ask you counter questions. They are going to maybe sometimes debate. They are into debate with you. They try to prove their point. But what may those points be, you need to think first so that you prepare your presentation in a strong manner. Okay, so planning a presentation, when you plan a presentation, always make a study or a good study of the audience that you are going to face. Okay, so yes, next slide, please. Next slide. Hello. Please change the slide. Yes. So what I'm going to speak up today is the TEL mechanism, or we call it the 3T mechanism. What does that mean? The 3T mechanism is a mechanism wherein we focus mainly on the introduction, body, and the conclusion. How should the introduction be? Introduction should be 15 to 20% of your presentation should be for the introduction. Only 15 to 20. Body of the presentation will be for 60 to 70%, and 15 to 20% of the time should be for the conclusion. Okay, under introduction, we are going to speak about the agenda, the context, and all the points, the problem statement, whatever is there, we are going to introduce that topic first. Second is address the topic directly with points, with subpoints, with details, everything. We are going to speak about the topic chosen. And the conclusion should be you tell them what you have already told them. That is, you repeat your points again. You make a recap of those things. And what is the takeaway from this presentation? What are the points of action? You try to repeat those points. So the 3T, they say you keep on telling them, reminding them that this is our topic and these are the points that I have covered. And this is the conclusion. So we keep on telling them. We call it the 3T mechanism. So this is the people use this when they prepare a presentation. So how much time is to be given for introduction, body, and conclusion? Now, my next slide will be about the introduction part. How should the introduction be? When you go in for a presentation, what is the importance of introduction and how it should be? Can you please change the slide? Please change the slide. Okay, they say always begin your introduction with a bang, they say. What does it mean? Bang doesn't mean a sound there. Begin with a bang means you start with something very, very interesting, with very, very, some very relevant questions may be asked. You can throw a question to the audience. You can.
Excuse me, ma'am, your voice is not audible. Okay, till ma'am joins, we will continue with our discussion which we left behind. Like, can anyone summarize any part that they have understood till now?
Yes, a short summary.
Come on guys, you can summarize even in one or two lines also.
Anybody? even assist
even can, assist can.
Yes, Srinivas, you were trying to say something. You can continue.
Hello.
Yes.
Our presentation must be interactive and purposeful, so audience can listen it.
Yes, that's damn true. Like our presentation should be interactive. That's the main point. Does anyone want to say something rather than that? Even second year, third year students can speak, final year students also.
Hello.
Yes.
Yes.
Here the contents of the presentation and the way we present it will play an important role in for the people in understanding it.
Yes, that's true.
And what do you think about the previous session by Rohit sir? Like it was too good from my side. Like I can't even describe those. Like any feedback from first year students?
Yes, previous session was too good. Hello.
Yes, yes, yes. You can speak.
Sir told very minute things like about color, font, font size, figures, tables, references.
Yeah, that's really true. Even the line that sir told, like before being a good engineer, you have to be a good human being. That really hit me hard.
Yes, 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 yes. Me too.
What about the other, especially FEs? Ma'am has joined, so we can continue now.
Yeah, okay. Just wait. Are the slides visible to you all? Because
yes,
from my side,
visible.
From my side, I'm having a problem. So I'll ask you to change the slide. I have mine here. Because it's not visible to me from my side.
Okay, ma'am.
Just wait. Just a second. Okay. Because from my side, I can't see the slides that you people are presenting. So they're not visible actually. You are sharing the screen, no?
Ma'am, the introduction yes, ma'am. Slide is visible.
Okay, because from here, for me, it's not visible. I'll speak on the topic, no problem. No problem. Okay, so introduction, through the introduction, we try to tell the purpose or the agenda of the presentation. That is, we try to introduce our main idea, the agenda, what I want to share with my audience is presented through introduction. And secondly, we try to build a rapport with the audience there. Rapport, you build a relation with them. When I speak to you, suppose I need to present in such a way that you start listening to what I'm saying. A rapport is built, at least to know what he or she is speaking. And of course, to grab the attention. That is why I said we use relevant questions, we use facts, we use, sometimes they use a joke. But this depends again on where you are presenting. That's why where we present is very important, the place where I'm presenting. If it is a technical presentation, a serious topic on which you are speaking, you cannot begin with a joke there. You can use some good lines, some good ideas, some thoughts you can present and begin your presentation. And they say, always give the audience why they should listen to you. Give them the reason. They should find more connected towards what you are saying. Otherwise, you will not be successful in what you are presenting. So the purpose of any presentation is given in the first part of the presentation, that is the introduction of the topic, which needs to be with the bang. We say we need to have catchy introduction always. We learned that word also. What is this catchy? You need to break that ice so that when you speak, they start listening to what you're saying, what you're presenting. Okay, so the first part of our presentation is introduction, as I said. And as we say, 15 to 20% of the time of the total time of presentation should be given to the introductory part. Now, after introduction, so they say always keep your introduction small, simple, and short. Because if you go on speaking in the introduction only, if you are going to go on speaking a lot, then people may lose interest in what you are saying. They may not, after a point, okay, she's not getting to the point. That happens, he or she, if you are not getting. So introductions should be very short, crisp, and to the point. And of course, as I said, open with a bang. They say always shock your audience. What does it mean? You make them alive, make them active in what you're saying. Otherwise, the audience is passively looking here and there. You use these techniques to shock them, the shock mechanism, they say. By using this shock mechanism, we try to make the audience awake. We try to reach out to them, create a rapport with them. Okay. Yes, next slide, please. Once you introduce your topic, then comes the most important part of our introduction, and that is knowing your content. Like, what am I going to speak to them? The content is, or people call it as a content also, some of them, is an important part again. Because through this content or content, you are presenting some concrete evidences. You are showing your findings, how ready you are on the topic. You're going to present these things through the content itself. So the content of the presentation is an important, what we call the body of the presentation, the main body of presentation, which is again an important one. Most people fail to make effective presentation because they try to convey so much of information and include so many ideas, they say. You include lots and lots of information, which is wrong. What should be done? This will spoil the presentation because it may confuse the audience on what topic you are speaking. They will not understand anything. Excessive data should also spoil the presentation. Okay, in short, we can say the mantra is to use few main points with relevant supporting details should be presented. Few points should be presented with some supporting material, supporting data should be presented. And the speaker should concentrate on these main points itself and use the appropriate transitions, connecting devices, connecting words to connecting one point to another. He or she should ensure that the information that I am giving to you, for example, it is accurate, it is complete, and relevant. So content or the body of presentation is an extremely important part. And a lot of hard work, a lot of research is required. And when you prepare your content, always keep your findings, your testimonials, everything ready. It should not be that at the end you start searching out, what did I say, where did I find this? No, you should be fully prepared. Ensure that the information is accurate. it is complete and relevant. And how it is prepared, it's a long way, long process, which we can discuss at some other point. But right now, for the FEs, in developing the sequence of presentation, transitions from one section to another, using good illustrations, and emphasizing on the points, important points, you prepare a good content. So it involves, we say content involves some central idea, some main points, and a lot of supporting materials which support your idea, which support your main point that you are speaking. And of course, use of visual aids is also equally important. Okay, so that is, first is introduction, second was your content, and third part is, which I'll be speaking of, before the conclusion, when you present, there is one more point which is very, very important, that is the body language and appearance. Please change the slide. Body language and appearance. Now, what is this body language? The students, you have studied about this in your first year, I guess. Studied about the nonverbal communication skills. Of course, your content is important, introduction is important, conclusion is important. But along with that, the body language or the appearance is extremely important. Now, what do these include? Have you changed the slide? Hello?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Okay. The body language include, first and foremost, the gestures. What are these gestures? Is the strike zone, they say. For example, the hand gestures that you are using, the hands. Many times students use their hands as they please, moving around everywhere. No, that is not the right way of presenting. When you use gestures, you need to use them in a limited way. The best way, I'll tell you, when you are using it, is you use your gestures, they say, from the elbow. Elbow, you don't use a whole hand, don't raise your hands. From the elbow, we use the gestures. I'll give you an example. Imagine that you are holding a box in your hand, and you are moving in and out, to the sides, over, down, holding a box in your hand. So try to move out and around with the box. So that should be your gestures. Not from the shoulder, it should be from the elbow here, down. Don't raise your hand, it should be from the elbow. So the example I gave you was holding a box in your hand. And avoid to clap the box. Clapping should be avoided by presentation. Many students do that. They are either clapping their hands, or they are playing with their rings. So these things, or cracking their knuckles, this thing should be avoided. That shows that you're not prepared properly. Your body language is not a positive one. So that's why they say, suppose you're holding a box in your hand, how would you use your hands there? That should be your gesture, hand gestures. Don't count finger on from your fingers. Suppose you're presenting something and you count on your fingers and just to use some body language. Always they say open palms is the good way of presenting. Palms, your hands. You should use openly. What type of a body language? Look at, even though it is a simple one, gesture, it involves so many things. Your confidence, your attitude, which is expressed through your gesture. Never use loud gestures. Many times I said, using a whole hand moving around here and there, don't do that. Because loud gestures are very irritating. People find it very, because they lose their track. They are no more interested in your topic there. They are more interested in how you're moving around. But when you're speaking to too large audience, their loud gestures can be allowed, but not in a technical presentation which you people will be preparing. So you need to use your hand gestures properly. Then comes our posture. Posture is how I sit, how I stand, how I carry around. At the end of it, it's based on body language. So you can make out how your posture, how you stand, how you move around there, it affects your presentation. They say always make mindful moments where it is not necessary, just don't move around. Wherever it's necessary, just use your posture, proper movement. Do not lean. Suppose you're using a lectern there, don't lean over it, or do not slouch. So when you stand, how should you have? You have a good strong body language with standing straight. Okay, so that is posture. Movement, as I said, unnecessary movement should be avoided. Then comes eye contacts. They say do not scare away the people through your eye contact. Many times when the people present, they are staring at someone. Just by looking at someone, you are not developing an eye contact there. They say the eye contact should not be more than 2 to 3 seconds. Suppose you are looking at a person, at the most 2 to 3 seconds you can look at that person, not more than that, because otherwise it becomes staring. And just move around, look around when you are speaking, because no one should feel neglected, particularly those at the back. If you don't look at them, they may feel neglected, lose interest in what you're saying. But in order to have that proper command over the audience, proper eye contact should be maintained. Then speaking about facial expressions, we all know why it is important. The eyes, they say, are regarded as a windows to the soul. What does that mean? The person, when you begin a presentation with a pleasant smile on your face, that shows your confidence, your zeal, your enthusiasm is reflected through this. The way you express your attitude for being a speaker here, it is reflected through your facial expression. So never, always start with a smile. And the smile has to be a light one. Don't start with a wide smile there. Okay, because it can also be irritating. And we say smile can work wonders, but sometimes it may also convey some negative expressions. Like, for example, if you are always smiling throughout the presentation, you are smiling, it says that you are not a serious person. Smile, begin your presentation with a smile, come back to your topic and present it in a normal way. I don't mean that you need to have a frown on your face or a smirk on your face, but present it in a way in which the audience will feel interested in what you're saying. And lastly, dressing and grooming, which is an important part. Grooming is how you maintain yourself. Always they say when you go for a technical presentation or a formal presentation, suit up. Suit up, wear proper suit, which our students know it, your seniors know it. They are always formally dressed when they go in. But never overdress also. Never put on too much of makeup or too much of some weird hairstyles or something like that, which are going to attract the audience towards that. Okay, so you must be proper shoes, proper hairstyle. Dressing should be formal when you go in for a presentation. So body language refers to all these things, not just your posture and gesture. It also includes your eye contact. It includes your expression on the face, your dressing, your grooming, and all the other things there. So having a positive body language is extremely important. Please change the slide. Next point that I will be discussing is your visual aids. When you use your proper visual aids, your presentation is always more effective. What are these visual aids? You will be using your slides, you will be using picture clippings, you will be using all these things in order to make your presentation more effective. Okay, so when we use those visual aids, they serve as speech notes, we say. What does it mean? They are used to, you can emphasize your points, clarify the main points through, and also make your presentations more effective through these visual aids. Good visual aids may increase the presenter's self-confidence because they help him or her to refresh. Suppose I forget a point, I can just look back and refer to the slide that I'm presenting. So that will help me in establishing more credibility in what I'm saying. It shows that I have planned my project, my presentation properly. I'm well prepared. And as professional, showing your confidence, self-confidence is very, very important. Thirdly, they help the presenter to focus on the theme, the main point of presentation. He or she may use visuals to highlight the central idea. So the main theme of presentation is always highlighted through the presentation. Next will be interesting and relevant visual aids will make the audience more interested in what I'm saying. If I use good visual aids, interesting ones, good relevant to the topic I'm speaking about, automatically the audience starts listening to what I'm saying. Many times it is said that visual aids may sometimes force even a hostile and demotivated audience to pay attention to what I'm saying. Hostile and demotivated, many times you attend this presentation because there is a compulsion. So in such a situation, if you are using good visual aids along with the good body language, you and of course the content, which is the main part there, you may make even a demotivated, disinterested audience to listen to what you are saying. And finally, they give the presentation, they make the presentation easy to understand. Many times for many students or many audience, the topic sometimes they cannot grasp. When you look at those images, when you look at those visual aids, automatically you feel more interested in what you're saying. So using planning your visual aids is very important. But again, you have a problem here. Only relevant visual aids must be used, which should match with the message or the topic you are speaking. Okay, just because you're good at it, PowerPoint or some programming, you cannot use anything. Special care must be taken while designing these presentations, because making presentations depends on electronic, based only on electronic media or visuals, may sometimes create handicaps. They say death by PPT. What does it mean? You'll use so many PPTs, so much of visual aids that you're not able to convey your ideas. It is called as death by PPT, which should not happen. So visual aids must be introduced. And of course, they must be introduced before you start speaking on them. And don't look at them and speak. Eye contact should be with the audience. The visual aids are for them to look and read. You should be able to present yourself, speak on those topics. And finally, the last point is closing of a presentation. When I close my presentation, how should I do it? Please change the slide there. Yes, can you please, will you please close this, change the slide? The closure of presentation or the conclusion part, they say, it should accomplish four specific objectives. That is, you should achieve 4 points there. What are those points? First and foremost, you summarize the presentation. The whole presentation is summarized in a few lines. We said 15 to 20% of the total time. You re-emphasize the central idea. That is, you repeat it again and again. You focus on the goal there, whatever you wanted to achieve. You focus on that. What does that mean? The speaker should focus on specific objective. Concentrate on what he or she wants to the audience to do. Whether you want them to think on your topic, whether you want them to change some points there, whether they remember what you have said, all this. What is your goal there? And of course, you motivate the audience. That is, the audience should be motivated to give a feedback. They must feel encouraged to ask you a question. Okay. And of course, last point that we have here is verbal techniques may also be used. That is, when you go in for a presentation, for example, you can use phrases or words such as in conclusion, it can be said, or lastly, or finally, or you may say, at last, my last point would be, such words which show, which emphasize your closure, which convey that the presentation has come to an end. So provide a closure, they say proper conclusion should be provided. Again, conclusion is an important part. You end on a positive note always. Don't be grumpy, don't be a negative person conveying negative ideas at the point. Even though it may be a serious topic, presenting in a positive way is very important, in a strong manner. Okay, so these are what we call, when you're going for a presentation, there are the elements there which you have to keep in mind. So firstly, know your audience, whom you are addressing to. Secondly, know the content, what you are going to present. Third is the three tell mechanism, that is your introduction, the body of presentation, and your conclusion. Introduction 15 to 20% of the time, body to 60 to 70%, and conclusion 15 to 20% of the time. And once you do that, we come to the body language and movement, your appearance, your posture, your gestures, etc. Then comes our most important point, and that is the visual aids that we use. Plan your visual aids properly, because your effectiveness of your presentation depends on that also. Don't use too many slides there or picture clippings there. I said avoid death by PPT. Don't do that, because many times that happens. And of course, you need to be very careful that you use relevant slides, relevant visual aids to the topic on which you are speaking. And of course, you can change the slide there. Certain things, avoid distractions to be avoided. Whenever you go in for a presentation, there are bound to be troublemakers who don't listen to what you are saying. Okay. And who keep on creating a problem. How to deal with them? First is neglect them, or if possible, give them a good, you can looking at them, you can present your ideas that will give you more confidence, because these troublemakers will help us to be more stronger. And secondly, avoid playing with your watch, your ID, or with your ring on your finger. These distractions are going to be there. They are guaranteed distractions. People coming, going out, moving around. So you should not get diverted or distracted from the main topic. And lastly, my last slide, please change it, are some few tips that people can just read it out, how to improve your presentation skills. Many times, for many speakers, it's the first time, first year students particularly, many of them tell me, ma'am, we have never been on the stage. How to speak from there? So you can do one thing, prepare your presentation, then try it out once, twice, but don't overdo it also. Many times students do it again and again and again, and they get so stressed, even though they know the points, they can present it well. At the final juncture, something goes wrong and they're not able to present. So see that you practice it, but not too many times. They say it's overwhelming if you do it many times. Yeah, best thing is you practice in front of mirror. See that you are natural in your presentation, body language particularly, eye contact, your posture, how you stand, how you look. All these things, the best way is you stand in front of the mirror and then practice. Okay. And if possible, suppose many of you, once the college reopens, you can have, that's why we conduct those activities. You can come on the stage there, present it to the audience. So how you can compare your presentation in front of the mirror, how you presented, and suppose there is an audience in front of you, how you present there. Okay. So, and you set a goal for yourself, see that they are realistic goals. Don't set that today I'm going to present it in such a strong manner, no one is going to like something. Some people have that. Just because I'm good at my language, I'm confident enough, doesn't mean that my presentations are effective. It involves all the other things where we need to work upon. And lastly, I gave you the example, don't speak too fast. Speaking too fast, you will not be able to convey your ideas to the audience there. There may be some who may not understand you also. Avoid repetitions. Some words, students repeat it, you know, you keep on saying that, don't do that, avoid repetitions, or repetitive, or when I present it, for example, the pauses that we use, vocalized pauses, you forget something, don't do those things. So for that, we need to practice it. So dear students, my only message to you all would be, plan your presentations properly. Whom you are addressing, where you are addressing, your content, your body language, introduction, body, and conclusion. Secondly, prepare it in a best manner. Pay attention to the content you are presenting, to whom you are presenting, what you are presenting, what will be. Suppose they ask you a question, what would they be? Okay, all these things. And finally, practice, because only through practice you are going to become perfect in this skill. And you as students of engineering, you are going to need this skill a lot. The presentation skills that you will be learning. So my focus was on the other parts. Sir spoke about the technical parts, but mine was more towards how to prepare a presentation. Content, how it is to be presented, sir spoke about it. But mine was on your body language, your visual aids, etc. Please change the slide. The one on, now here you have a picture of this person. Look here, his eye contact, smile, posture, he's facing the audience. Look at his hand gestures, he's pointing towards the slide there, but he's not having his back towards the audience. So they say sometimes your body is speaking so loudly that I can't hear what you're saying. That should not happen. Your body language should be such that it merges, or when you present it, people don't get attracted towards that part there. Next slide, please. The one of Obama with open palms. Don't keep your closed palms. Open palms means your palms are open like this, and look at his hands also. He is using it from he's not raising his hand from the shoulder. Okay, so this is the way it needs to be, with the gesture of what you understand by open palms. And last one, we have one more. Here, look at, please choose the gesture which reflects a body language. Number one shows that he's thinking something. He's there, but he's not present there. Physically present, but mentally somewhere else. Number two is something, she's sitting in the, he or she, we don't get the right way, in the dark. So people are not interested in knowing what that person is saying. Three is with full open palms, how he's presenting. Look at, it becomes too overconfident. Four, she's nervous. The lady is a bit nervous to speak. So she's having look at the hands, how she has kept it. Number six is too loud. So number five, look at the way he is presenting, how he is standing. That is the right way, right posture. Okay, next, last slide, please. Again here, the one with the one which has been circled, he has a small smile on his face, which is a right way, a positive way of presentation. The one above there, he's very depressed. He looks very sad. The one below shows he's tensed. And the lady, Julia Roberts, I guess, she is smiling a lot, which is not right also. When you present it, see that you don't smile a lot. What's the first one is the right facial expression, a small smile on the face. Okay, so that comes to the end of my presentation. Thanks a lot for listening, and hope to see you all presenting more with more confidence. Of course, I haven't touched upon topics, topic like the language, for example. So communication skills are important. Good communication skills are important. Using correct pronunciation, correct articulation, correct sentences, don't form wrong sentences grammatically. Okay, so I wish you all the best for your future, and I would like to see you all presenting more confidently. And again, Sesa, all the members, thanks a lot for having me here. It was a good experience sharing my views with you all. Okay, thank you.
Thank you.
Yes, thanks a lot, ma'am. That was a beautiful session. We learned so many new things today.
Thank you.
Thanks a lot, ma'am.
Thank you.
So now, here we are with one surprise for you all, guys. I think if you have read the message carefully, you will get to know. You are right. There is going to be a competition regarding the presentations.
Yes, I hear and I forget. I see and I remember. But when I do, then only I understand. So this is the starting of that journey to the happiness. But when we apply that knowledge and explore our skills, then we understand. This is why the competition is essential. I would not say it is a competition, but the second most essential step of that journey to the success and hence thereafter leading to the happiness.
So the event is just the beginning. The first round, and then there will be a second round where you will be given an opportunity to climb up the second most essential step, that is applying. And this is going to be too exciting, interesting, with lot of fun and knowledge.
Yes, there will be one surprise competition for you guys, as we mentioned. The details of the same will be provided later on, and a Google form will be circulated soon. So you have to stay tuned.
Yes, we have saw the two sessions of our guests. The sessions were too awesome and interactive, but we might have some doubts. So for clearing that doubts, we will take a live question answer session. Those who are having any kinds of doubts can put the question into the chat box, and then we will request you to unmute, and then you can ask the question to our guests. So those who want to ask question, they can put a dot in chat box. Any, especially from FS, we want questions. Yes, Vishal, you can unmute yourself and ask questions. Hello, Vishal. Okay, Riddhi, you can unmute and ask question.
Hello.
Yes.
So my doubt is that if I'm allotted a particular time duration, like if I'm allotted 1 hour to speak, so how can I manage that time? That how do I know that I'll finish my presentation, specifically clearly in that time duration? Hello, is that question for me?
Yes, ma'am, you can answer.
Okay. No, look, suppose generally your technical presentation at this level is for 10 minutes, but if you're given a longer time, like 1 hour presentation, once you go, suppose you have to give a technical presentation, there practice makes you perfect. That's why I said practice, that because you need to divide that timing. Like for introduction,
yes,
percent of the total time. So how much will that be? 10 to 15% of your total 1 hour, give it to the introductory part. Okay. And then comes your topic, how you are going to present it with the help. So, the content that you will be presenting. Because it's the most important part, the various dimensions that you will be presenting through your presentation. Of the content, what you're presenting. So the maximum part of your presentation will be for the body. That is 60 to 70%. Then you prepare it.
Yes.
And of course, you need to think about it. When you're preparing a presentation, are you going to use the PPT there? If you're using the PPT, how much time will you be giving to that part? And of course, as I said, 15 to 20% of the total time to the conclusion. And of course, best thing is practice.
You prepare a presentation, practice it. Only practice can make you perfect. And try it.
Yes, ma'am.
And try it out constantly. The last slide I gave you. Practice makes you perfect. Plan it properly and practice it. Okay.
Okay. Thank you, ma'am.
Welcome.
Yes, now Saili, you can unmute yourself and ask questions.
Hello, am I audible?
Yes, you are audible.
Hello, ma'am. If something is messed in my presentation, like the PPT is messed, so how could I wind up this thing?
Okay, so it is suppose this happens many times, okay, when you prepare a PPT. That's why I said avoid death by PPT, which means even that. Yes, they say don't put every word you want to say in the PPT itself. You can, that's why preparing is more important. You prepare the topic well. Even if the PPT goes wrong there, you can come back to your point again. Because this happens many times. We prepare it with so much of hard work, we take so much of time, it consuming it is, but it may happen that we may end up something may go wrong there and you may not be able to use the correct PPT or something happens. For that, you should be prepared from your side. Doesn't matter, you move further from that point. So preparing the content properly with concrete evidences, with research findings, everything. So when you prepare it properly, you won't be dependent on the PPT there. So that is the main thing. It is used, visual aids, they enhance your presentation. But presentations is what you present there, the content that you have prepared, how you are going to present it. Okay, so don't totally depend on PPT.
Okay, ma'am, thank you.
Now,
Shraddha, you can ask the question by unmuting.
Hello, my question is for Amangalekar sir, that till now, when we use logos on title slide, we used to put it in top corners. And as you suggested, there was at bottom. So which is appropriate way to put logos?
I guess, who's that? To ask the question, Shraddha? Yes, actually, I asked you to divide the slide into three parts. The topmost part, that is a header section, generally we use it for the titles. I don't know where you have seen it, and these kind of rules probably change with the institute. For the two colleges I have studied in, WC and COAP, both of them preferred the placement of logo in the footer section. Okay, in the footer section, generally we use the logo, the name of the college, the date, and the slide number. Okay. So preferably the footer section is the one where you should put the logo, and the header section is for the titles. So it will just again create a kind of too much content on the main part of the slide. So footer section is the appropriate place, I guess.
Yes, sir. Thank you.
Thanks a lot, sir and ma'am, for clearing our doubts by answering our questions. So, this event was successful, but behind this success of this event, there were many working hands who strived to make this event more successful. So, for giving the vote of thanks, I would like to invite Associate Secretary of SESA, Ms. Shrushti Mende.
Yes. Thank you, Sanraj. Am I audible?
Yes, Shrushti.
Okay, fine. Welcome you all. Hello everyone. A warm and awe-inspiring afternoon to all present over here. On the behalf of SESA and Walchand College of Engineering Sangli, it's a very ironic and a noteworthy event like this. And of course, to grab this vibing moment and fruitful interaction with our guest, Mr. Rohit Mangalekar sir and Mrs. Anushree Kulkarni ma'am. We all know that the goal of education is understanding, but the goal of training is performance. And of course, engineers are meant for their skillful contrivance. Thank you so much, sir and ma'am. You immensely pleasured us with your presence, and your guidance has definitely fed the thirst of such skillful learning in an artful manner. I express my gratitude towards staff advisor of CESA, Professor A.K. Mahi sir, for granting permissions and supporting us throughout. I would thank Chief Board of CESA for igniting our imagination and guiding us at best. I must mention deep sense of appreciation to all associate and assistant board for their hard work while organizing and coordinating all over. Moreover, to make this event blissful in every aspect, I am intensely thankful to all audience present over here. If I have forgotten to mention any name, please forgive me. I have heard many a times that every successful presentation is built on four pillars. That is people, idea, passion, and preparation. So first three pillars can be constructed by taking help from other systems. But for fourth one, you need strong bars of your own hard work. And of course, today's event will highlight a correct way for executing your skillful life very much. So once again, thank you each one of you. Hereby, I conclude this ceremony officially. So stay safe, keep learning and executing your skills at the best. Have a good day ahead. Except board members, everyone can leave the meet. Thank you.
Thanks a lot, Shrushti. But before leaving the meet, I would again tell you that tomorrow there would, regarding the competition, the message would be there on your group. So all of you, please be ready for that.
Thank you.
Yes, thanks a lot.
Thank you, sir.
For your precious presence, have a good day and a good weekend as well.
Yes, have a good day and a good weekend.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you for the session.
Thank you, CSDs.